फाइव सेकेंड, टू सेकेंड, रेडी। सेक्शन 13(1) एंड 2 ऑफ द सरफेसी एक्ट 2002 कोटेड अबव प्रोसीड्स ऑन द बेसिस दैट सिक्योरिटी इंटरेस्ट नीड्स टू बी इन्फोर्स्ड एक्सपेंडिशली विदाउट इंटरवेंशन ऑफ द कोर्ट आर एनी ट्रिब्यूनल द लेजिस्लेटिव पर्पज फॉर कन्फर्मिंग द पावर ऑन द सिक्योर्ड क्रेडिटर टू इन्फोर्स इट्स सिक्योरिटी इंटरेस्ट बाई टेकिंग रिकोर्स टू सेक्शन 13(4) ऑफ द सरफेसी एक्ट 2002 विदाउट इंटरवेंशन ऑफ द कोर्ट इज टू फ्री द सिक्योर्ड क्रेडिटर ऑफ द इम्पेडिमेंट कंटेंड इन सेक्शन 69 ऑफ द ट्रांसफर ऑफ पॉवर्टी एक्ट अंडर द प्रोविजन्स ऑफ द सरफेसी एक्ट 2002 अ सिक्योर्ड क्रेडिटर इज एम्पावर्ड बाई वर्च्यू ऑफ सेक्शन 13 ऑफ द सेड एक्ट टू टेक एनी ऑफ द मेजर इंक्लूडिंग द सेल ऑफ सिक्योर्ड एसेट्स विदाउट इंटरवेंशन ऑफ द कोर्ट एंड नॉट विथ स्टैंडिंग द लिमिटेशन ऑफ सेक्शन 69 ऑफ द ट्रांसफर ऑफ पॉवर्टी एक्ट एज वुड बी एविडेंट फ्रॉम परजुअल ऑफ स्टेटमेंट ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट एंड रीजन्स ऑफ द एक्ट वन ऑफ देम इज फैसिलिटेटिंग रिकंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ फाइनेंशियल एसेट्स एक्वायर्ड बाई एक्सरसाइजिंग पावर्स ऑफ इन्फोर्समेंट ऑफ सिक्योरिटीज आर चेंज ऑफ मैनेजमेंट आर अदर पावर्स विच आर proposed to be conferred on the banks and financial institutions. The scheme of the Surfacey Act 2002 makes it clear that it does not deal with the dispute between the secured creditors and the borrower, and on the contrary, it deals with the rights of the secured creditors. The Act proceeds on the basis that the liability of the borrower has crystallized and his account stands classified as non-performing asset in the hands of bank or financial institutions. Non-performing account is an account which becomes non-viable and non-performing in terms of the guidelines issued by the Reserve Bank of India. Such account is an asset available with the bank and financial institution as it represents some receivables and realization by the bank or financial institution, and in that sense it is an asset in the hands of the secured creditors. Surfacey Act 2002 was primarily enacted to reduce the non-performing assets by adopting such measures for recovery which was fast and uninterrupted by any intervention of the court or tribunal, but also for reconstruction. Under the provisions of the Surfacey Act 2002, all the rights vested in the secured creditors in respect of a non-performing account, which is a crystallized liability, could be assigned to the asset management company and asset reconstruction company, which in term steps into the shoe of the secured creditor, namely the bank or the financial institution. The same is clearly reflected from a bare reading of Section 5 of the Surfacey Act 2002, as well as the definition of the asset reconstruction contained in Section 2B and secularization in Section 2Z and Section 10 of the Act, which prescribes the function of secularization company and the reconstruction company under which it can act as an agent of any bank or financial institution for the purpose of recovering dues from the borrower on payment of such fee and charges as may be mutually agreed upon between the parties.